Some people they assume is as easy as that your 5G switch to 4G, and in the old days used to switch to 3G. Unfortunately, that is not the case. This is very important. Even if you have one bar 5G, one bar 4G, or even just the one bar, the terrestrial connection does not allow you to use your satellite. Either you have to have iPhone 14, 15, or 16, most likely this year the new one 17, or you have to have a Samsung S25. Hi guys, imagine you are in the place like this, so beautiful, so natural, and this is just lovely. But there is an issue. Sometimes we don't have 5G, we don't have 4G, and things can happen. We can get a snake bite, we could have an off-road vehicle that is broken down and we need help, or simply we are running late and we want to let our loved one know where we are so they don't have to get worried. As you might know, until now, Apple provided the iPhone 14, 15, and 16 with the emergency services using a satellite. So what it means is, if something goes wrong, you had to actually use that service and contact emergency services such as ambulance, police, etc. Okay? You could share your location, you could message them, and you could contact them. Until last week. Okay, last week, Telstra made a deal with SpaceX using a Starlink up there and enabling us to be anywhere in Australia and connect to the satellites and to let our loved one know our location, why we are running late, or if you have an injury or the emergency, we can let the mate know to come and pick us up or get help. So, how does it all this work? Firstly, there's a hardware part to it. Either you have to have iPhone 14, 15, or 16, most likely this year the new one 17, or you have to have a Samsung S25. Now, there is a rumor S24, 21, etc. would be enabled. Personally, I doubt it because they don't have the satellite modem or the satellite antenna to communicate with satellite, unless Telstra is using a different technology that I'm not aware of. Okay, so don't take my words for it yet. This video, I'm going to discuss iPhone, obviously. And on the next video, we're going to discuss Android. So if you have an Android, please like and follow me so you can watch my next video and make sure you press the bell button. Now we go back to the iPhone. Now there's other part of this program, how it works. So you have to be basically assigned to Telstra. You have to have a membership with Telstra, and you cannot be with Optus or Vodafone, at least at this time. So Optus, Vodafone, they do not offer it. I'm pretty sure in near future they will offer as well. But if you are in a rush, then you have to switch from the Optus or Vodafone to Telstra. Now, I have no affiliation with Telstra. I'm just telling you the facts. Okay? If you have no rush, just like I'm pretty sure Optus and Vodafone, they're going to bring this technology as well. So, one part is the carrier, the Telstra in Australia, and another part is your hardware, which we covered. Now, some people, they assume is as easy as that your 5G switch to 4G, and in the old days used to switch to 3G. Unfortunately, that is not the case, and you got to know how to do this correctly. Because if you are in emergency, if you are frustrated, things does not happen just like that. And the reason doesn't happen because we don't have satellites constantly above us. So satellites, they come and they go, and we got to be ready to connect to them and track them. So sort of you are moving and Apple will tell you go back, forth, or go which direction. To do this, the easiest way that I find is using a control center. Please make sure you create the second page and add your connection section to it. So then you have a satellite option. Remember, this is very important. Even if you have one bar 5G, one bar 4G, or even just the one bar, the terrestrial connection does not allow you to use your satellite. Okay? Now, when you go off-grid like here, what happens is, this is very interesting. satellite icon will appear. You will see it and will tell you there is a satellite connection. But if you see the icon, the system doesn't work yet. What you got to see instead of that icon, you have to get to see SAT, S-A-T, short for satellite. All right? And you got to be ready to send that message at the time, which I suggest type your message beforehand, okay, and do that. Now, to get that happening, basically, you will go to our messaging app, which is normally iMessage, okay? You cannot use WhatsApp or the Signal, etc., because this is only text message. This is not using the internet to deliver your message. It's just using the old school text message. Therefore, you can send the message from the iPhone to an Android, okay? And you can send the Android to an iPhone, Android to Android, iPhone to iPhone, any device that uses the text message. You can even send the message most likely to a Nokia phone, the old school phone, because it's just the text message, okay? So what you got to do, you go to your control center, okay? We go page up and you will see the satellite. When you click on that, if you are not seeing the message there yet, SMS or message, and it's just showing you demo, which means there is no satellite up there nearby yet. You got to move. You can do the demo. That's what I'll find. You can do the demo and Apple will tell you, okay, move to the left, move to the right, etc. Okay? And when it's telling you, it's actually saying wait for the satellite to get there. Alright? So when you see the message part appear, you just tap on it. Your pre-text message is going to be there. And then you press send. As simple as that. You will see a bar going across at the top, as you can see here. And when it's sent, bang, it finished, right? If you connect again to this location, or you have your phone in your hand as you are walking, okay, or you are driving, for example, you have to put it on the dashboard, because the roof of the car, unless you have a big panoramic sunroof, moonroof, whatever you want to call it, okay, satellite signals cannot get to your phone. Okay, and that does not mean you are switching like from the 5G to 4G, that you are connected all the time. All right, satellite comes, satellite goes. They are going so fast across the earth, you have few seconds to send the message, and the loved one, friend, mate, whatever, that they send the message on that time, they will send. So the next time you connect to the satellite, you will receive the message as well. For test of this video, I've done it so far. Twice I send a message, and my friend TD sent me that it received it twice, and I just got it received. So, another thing what I find in my research, when we drive the car, if you keep your car, let's say you are doing about 5 to 20 kilometers per hour, it's going to stay connected as long as there is a satellite view in that duration. When the satellite passes, you get disconnected again. And because you are in that mode, it tries to connect to the next satellite, okay, which is pretty cool, right? Now, what I find is, when you go to 20 plus, 25, 30K, etc., you lose it and it says no reception whatsoever. And we have seen this on even the Starlink dish, okay? A Starlink dish is much bigger, is about 40 to 30 centimeters, something like that. It has lots of sensors. And it's connected on the different angle. We are looking at 100, I think it's 20 degree angle, okay, to the satellite. So since satellites appear, till satellite leaves, it connects it. So that's why it works while you're driving. Your phone, the space, the surface is this small, the antenna is small. That is why when you're going fast, does not stay connected, okay? Pretty much it. This is what you got to do. And if you like technology, you like outdoor, you like off-roading, you like hiking, please follow me, press the bell button, because I'm going to keep bringing you the tips and tricks and the technology that we can use to stay safe and basically make sure that our family, they are aware where we are, so they are enjoying their life, they don't have to worry about us while we are wandering around. Until next video, take care of yourself and loved ones.